Well, welcome back, everyone, to Mega Man X. I'm your host, That Guy, and we're going to be taking on the Chill Penguin. Is this the right person for me to play against? Probably not. I'm missing a lot of equipment, and as well as there are upgrades like the dash I told you about earlier. But to be honest, I don't remember where to get it. So we're going to just give it a shot and see how we go. I remember the boss being kind of easy, so maybe we'll be able to do this. And here they are. Nice little intro. This actually used to be my ringtone on my phone. Yeah, pretty sadistic. That symbol in the background is Sigma. If any of you are any good at maps, you'll know what Sigma actually is. Not the whole logo itself, but that just represents Sigma. And go chop some wood, huh? Here's the main enemy, and to be honest, when I was younger, I used to draw that all over the place in my books. I don't know what my fascination is of it at the moment, but I'm sure it was something ridiculous, but I do remember my parents telling me off and thinking that I was some sort of gang member and tagging things. Yeah, not that I actually had any form of spray cans or anything like that, or Texas for that matter. I just did in lead pencil in all my books for some reason. I think these bats are in all the Mega Man series actually now. I think they die in one shot. That's weird. Yeah, they die in one shot. Great. Pellet gun. Spud gun. Guys that are wheels that can't really attack you and they blow up after two shots. That's really sad. Okay, let's just get rid of them. So, how's everyone been? Just to let you guys know, I actually live in Australia. I know, that's a little different. There aren't many LPs from Australia, the Great Down Under, as some people might call it. Can I make that jump? Yeah, I can, of course. I've actually been inspired by quite a few people. I've been watching a lot of LPs in my spare time, which... Oh, I can't believe I got hit by that. I didn't even bother to move, even. But, hey, there's an upgrade right here in front of me. I'll just finish the story in a minute, and I'll just finish this up. So, you've come. I don't like to do that on command. Yeah, I like to have a bit of foreplay before I do that. This is Dr. Light, actually. Like Santa Claus hologram. X, I gave you the ability to choose your own path in life, but you're a robot, so I don't know if I can call it a life. And I hoped the world would allow you to choose a peaceful one. You know, considering that this is a computer program, I wouldn't be surprised if you actually talk like, you know, this is a chosen one, but now it seems that you are destined to fight. Round one, fight. Yeah. Okay, because I thought the world might need a new champion, I made you. But unfortunately, I made you, like, the alpha version. I wish I made the beta version first, because it would have made more sense. I have hidden capsules like this one. Why did you hide them? Did you at least put some sort of password protection that only I would know or something? Or at least made sure that, like, you know, only, I don't know, biologic signatures such as my own can open them? No, he chooses just to put it... It's not even hidden. It's in the middle of the stage. I think if anyone just walked along and got this, then, you know, they could probably turn it on and figure it out. If you find and use them, you will be able to increase your powers. Superhero powers. Shooting lasers out of your eyes. Or lasers out of your eyes, as I was about to say. Beyond anything that the world has ever known. Yes, you will be more powerful than anything. Even more powerful than... Astro Boy. Or some other robot, Robocop. Step into this capsule. Why don't you step into this capsule? And receive an acceleration system to boost your speed. And also it boosts your metabolism. Not that you'd probably need to eat anything. Good luck, X! Really, voice bad breaking! Okay, so yeah, whenever you find these, you just jump into it. And it gives you the power up. You'll see the flash, and then whatever part of you just got upgraded should change color. Yep. So the shoes. Boots, and I think they give you a demo of it. Yeah. Okay. So basically, to dash, you can double tap in one direction, left or right. Can't do upward ones. And yeah, it does. I gotta admit, it does look a bit weird considering that we used to be blue and now we got a bit of white in our color. Oh, that's not racist. I'm not trying to be racist by saying that. Ooh, emu, ostrich. As I was saying before, I was inspired to start doing Let's Plays from other Let's Players. I've watched a lot of Chugga Conroy's work. I've messaged him, but I'm guessing that he probably receives heaps of people messaging him, because you look at his stats and you kind of notice that there is just way too much happening there. Also in the Nintendo Capri Sun, Lugjin, Takari Freak, Proton John, who, well, let's face it, if you've watched his Kaizo Mario, it's worth it. Just watching that makes, you know, everything feel a little bit better. And yeah, just for the sake of it, yeah, don't eat the mushroom. Yeah, watch their stuff. You'll probably like it. It's a lot more on the humorous side. But all of them have really good channels, and they all really know what they're doing. As opposed to me right now, who has no real idea where I'm going. Just then, we were in a ride armor. In this game, that's the only real ride armor you get. Just a punching one, I believe. In the other X series, there are alternative ride armors which you can choose. I believe it's Megaman X3 where you get to choose between four different ones. Or otherwise, maybe in ones other than that, they give you other choices. But yeah. Okay, this little gate here signifies that we're about to have a boss battle. So hopefully I do well. You always have the mandatory nothing area where it's just like, hey, I'm going to lock the doors behind you, but because we know you're a robot and you're probably Smash Bros, we're going to double lock them. Close the blast doors. And here we are. It's penguin time. Don't look at me. Look at X. And bulletproof ice. Who would have thought? Oh, Jesus. Okay. And yeah, basically, he's got very simple attack patterns. I'm just trying to figure out how to do my dash jump, and it's not working. No, it's not working. Why is it not working? Oh god, I have like no health left. This is great. Am I going to be able to beat him with one health? Probably not. I'll try anyway. But there's just something wrong with my dash buttons, because normally you can do what's like a dash jump off the wall. Which is basically just an amped up jump. It's faster and it goes further distance, but I can't seem to do it right now, which is kind of weird. And oh, by the way, the dash, no air dash, which is what I'm used to in most games, but yeah. One health. Can I beat him? I'm being unusually cautious though, so. 3, 4. Oh, okay, there we go. As you can see, he does stun rather easy, even on your pellet shots. And, ooh, I can't believe I nearly fell for that. And pretty much from what you've seen just then, that's all his attacks. That's it. He's, what, 3, 4 attacks? That's it. And that was really close. And he will try to hit you with those little penguins. I gotta say, I work at a place that is retail, and I don't know what it is about Christmas, but we seem to have Christmas penguins. They kind of like dress up as Santa and things like that. And I got so carried away with my story that I didn't actually notice I beat him. I was just wondering, why is the screen turning white? Maybe it's just my eyes. Ta-da! Ta-da-da! Ching! Teleport away. Not that there's anything more important to do, but so, what does our weapon look like? You get shotgun ice, or the ice shotgun. Probably be a better name for it. And it's a pretty fast shot, but okay, why is it a shotgun? When it hits a wall, it actually reflects backwards. Yeah, it reflects backwards, not hitting the enemy and then proceeding through to become shrapnel and hit further targets, but it goes backwards. What the heck? Anyway, here's our password screen again. Again, if you want to copy it down, I don't know why you'd want to copy it down, because you could have just easily played this game yourself. And it'll take us back to the map screen. I think I'll leave it there. I hope you all enjoyed this, because to be honest, I'm really enjoying playing this and just talking to you guys, even though you can't talk back. So I'll leave it there. You guys have a good day, yeah? Take care of yourselves.